Next on Weather Underground, critical days ahead in the tropics.
Yeah, Tropical Storm Karen.
For staying with us tonight right here on Weather Underground, I'm Mike Bettis.
I'm Alex Wilson, and it is most certainly not fall. No.
Not even close.
It says it's fall, and we're all like, close. Where? Where?
West.
Where?
You got to go west. Yeah, there's even absolutely. Snow there.
That is true. You can find it. Might require a little travel. Mm-hmm. We're also still talking trust Omaha, but over to Des Moines, up into Minnesota, including areas around Minneapolis, and then that western part of the state of Wisconsin. Again, midnight local time, the expiration. But let's walk you through the storms. We already have these two to the north of Omaha. This one watching for not just hail, not just winds, but possibly a tornado. They've mentioned the possibility of that, but big hail likely out of this one. You can see that hot pink color, that core in that storm would be indicative of some large hail, even a little bit of that white showing up at times. So big hail, well in excess of an inch in Burt, Harrison, and Monona counties. This warning in effect until 5:30, and this will be moving out of Nebraska, over the river, and into western Iowa shortly. There would be our area of possible rotation. So right there along 75 would be the spot to watch, but not an overly strong area of rotation. Not going to take our eye off this one by any means. Not out of the question to see a tornado warning issued at some point with this storm. Hail likely out of this one as well. Cherokee, Ida, and Woodbury counties until 5:15. You're under the warning. You can see some trailing storms there. Areas to the north and west, of Sioux City firing up along that boundary very quickly. There again is our tornado watch. Here is a severe thunderstorm watch that remains in effect for parts of Kansas. The main threat out of storms down here would be hail. Can't discount winds, but hail likely out of both of these storms here. This one west of Pratt, you can see again that hot pink color. Pratt, Coates, Iuka, and Pratt are some of the communities in the path of this one. This warning in effect until 5:30. So a place like Pratt at 5:27. How about Skellyville at 6:15? This is skirting right along 400 too. So if you know somebody who may be traveling, it's going to be a tough go with the heavy rain and hail. Today's threat zone very much in line with where we currently have those active watches, Mike. Karen, Jerry, and Nab. Those are the names we've got to talk about. Also, Lorenzo. I wanted to throw you in with good company. I feel like I trust you more than a Karen or a Jerry.
Well, I'm a
Lorenzo,
troublemaker.
Lorenzo, I feel like I'm
sometimes
cool with.
Sometimes I'm a troublemaker, too.
A very reliable guy, isn't he?
Yeah, Rick. That's one
Rick.
I trust.
You know, Rick is on the East Pacific list, and Richard's on the Atlantic list, so I can cause trouble all kinds of
my goodness.
I feel like you had something to do with that.
No, actually. But Lorenzo, I still don't trust.
You know, one question we've been asked a lot is, has a hurricane ever formed near the equator? Storm specialist Dr. Greg Postel's got the answer. All severe modes on the table. Wouldn't even rule out an isolated tornado. Right now, east of Sioux City, that's where we've got a severe thunderstorm warning. You can see all the storms, though. They're producing some big-time lightning. So if you're hearing thunder, know the storm is dangerous enough. But here in Cherokee and Ida and Woodbury counties, we've got a severe thunderstorm warning. This storm likely producing some hail on the south side of I-20. Could also bring you those gusty winds that exceed 60 miles an hour, topple trees, or cause some minor damage in and around your home. You know, you get the shingles blown off, or if you've got a shed in the backyard, you can have problems there. Correctionville, a storm really right on your doorstep right now. Holstein at 4:49, and then 5:14 local time for the community of Alta. We get you down into Kansas. We've got a severe thunderstorm watch in place right now from Dodge City to Wichita. This is in effect until 10 o'clock. So the ingredients are in place for severe storms to develop. And we've got one strong severe storm east of Dodge City. So this is just east of Greensburg, Kansas. It's Edwards and Kiowa and Pratt counties under the warning. And this is moving right along 400, really just to the north of 400. And moving parallel, we've got this warning in effect until 5:30, eventually approaching the community of Pratt. So watch for hail, gusty winds out of that one as well. Severe storms possible anywhere from Kansas all the way up to Lake Superior. Highest likelihood, though, will be in that corridor from Omaha up into western Wisconsin, Mike.
Now, in other parts of the country, it's nothing but hot and dry.
Yes.
We cannot buy.
Yeah, you got it. Coming up on Weather Underground Tuesday, traffics aren't really signaling that things are quieting down anytime soon. We've got a lot to talk about there in the Atlantic. And thanks for you for staying with us. I'm Alex Wilson.
And I'm Mike Bettis. Let's get right to our hurricane expert, Dr. Rick Nabb, tonight for a look at everything tropics, including Karen, which obviously poses the most imminent risk tonight.
Yeah, and the risk is happening right now in portions of Puerto Rico and the
sun can lead to these severe storms. In fact, you want to get that daytime heating really going. The severe storms, they're popping here into the state of Iowa. In fact, a new tornado warning here on the northern of our two cells that we have been watching. This storm is moving east at 25 miles an hour. So it's right along the roadway there, just to the south, north of Ida Grove. We've got hail out of this one likely and a radar indicated tornado. So that's why they've gone ahead and issued that warning. You can see that general area of rotation north and west of Ida Grove. So this is going to be moving off towards the east. So again, generally staying south of the roadway there, south of Holstein, south of Schaller. Ida Grove and Arthur, these are two of the communities, though, that do need to be on alert for this one. In your lowest level, most interior room, in your safe spot. If you know somebody who may be out there in the area too, hail going to be a real threat out of this one. Hail, likely you can see some of that magenta, that hot pink color. That's indicative of that quarter plus sized hail. So big hail here in Harrison and Monona County, most likely. There is the threat for damaging gusty winds, so 60 mile per hour winds and big time rainfall. This will eventually be crossing over 30, but right now 30 not under that warning. 6:30 is the expiration on this one. There is an area of rotation. Sarah Dillingham, our weather producer, looking at this one really closely because, you know, we did show you the rotation at last check, and she's mentioned, and you can clearly see it here, it has been tightening up. So we'll have to watch this storm as well, see if perhaps a warning issued on that. Earlier, they were saying in the warning that there was the possibility that we could see a tornado warning come out of this storm. Pisgah, you're up next, then Allen, Woodbine, Dunlap, and Earling. Not the only storms to watch. We've got a tornado watch here for this entire area from Wisconsin into Minnesota through Iowa and Nebraska, Mike.
And then we
give you some perspective of where this is. We're looking at west central portions of Iowa. So we're well to the east of Sioux City. It's our northest from Iowa. You need to know if you're in the path of this, you need to get to your safe spot. So this is the storm that John's on right now, and this is moving due east across the area. Now the warning could soon expire. The rotation at this point is looking a little less distant.